Hello everybody. So in today's video I want us to have a look at how we can be able to block different websites, and for this example I'm going to use YouTube and Facebook, and this is just the same method that you can use to block any other website that you want to block access to. This is particularly important maybe if probably you have an office setup, and probably at some point you really don't want people working at the same time and they are on Facebook or YouTube at the same time. So this is a very effective way to accomplish that. So what you basically need to do is you come to IP. Then come to firewall. Then we are going to add just some two rules. Mostly I see some guys use layer 7 protocol, but I'd advise against using layer 7 protocol, because with layer 7 it really uses a lot of your MikroTik resources, and with that at times you find that the CPU usage goes very high, and that will really negatively affect the performance of your MikroTik router. So let's come to filter rules. So let's add our first rule. So you come to the general tab, the chain is going to be forward, and then the source address is going to be your LAN address. So let me just get my LAN address. So you come to IP addresses, and this is my LAN address. So let me just copy this, then I'm going to paste that here, and then after that the protocol that we are going to use is TCP, and the destination port for that is 443. Then we are going to go now to the advanced tab. And on the advanced tab, you're going to look for TLS host. And what basically TLS does is it collects and gathers all the YouTube servers or Facebook or whatever website that you want to block. And then you are going to be able to put them in an address list, so that you're now going to block or drop packets to that address list. So let's start with YouTube. So what you do is you put an asterisk. Then just write YouTube, another asterisk to close that. And then after that, you come to the action tab, and the action is going to add destination to address list. Our address list, maybe let's give it a name, and let's say, what name do we give it? Collect YouTube IPs, and we are going to give it a timeout. Let's say this could be 30 days. That's it. And then you just apply that. Okay. The second rule that you're going to add is you still come to the general tab, and the chain is still going to be forward. Then you come to the advanced tab, and then from the advanced tab, the destination address list, we are going to pick it from this drop down that we created, collect YouTube IPs. You're going to pick that, and then you come to the action, and the action here is going to be drop. So we can maybe give a comment here and say maybe this is a block YouTube. Okay. So what's going to happen now basically is once I start using YouTube, The MikroTik is now going to gather all the YouTube server addresses and add them to this address list. So let me just try using YouTube so that those address lists can all be gathered. It takes a bit of time for it to gather the address lists, and at times it may also require you to just restart your MikroTik router. So let me just do that. So I have just rebooted my MikroTik router. I've given it a minute, and it has collected some few addresses for YouTube server. So let's just go to YouTube and see. This was able to play before I started the configuration. So let's just try and refresh and see what happens. So you see, I'm trying to refresh this, and looks like it's not going to load. So when you come to Facebook, if I try to refresh that, you see it's refreshing very fast. And maybe let's just try and search for anything. The world. And yeah, you can see I have internet access, but I have no connection to YouTube. So that means I've been able to effectively block all traffic to YouTube. So let's just go back to our router. And now let's do the same for Facebook as well. So let's come back to our filter rules. I'm just going to copy my first rule, copy that. So the general tab is going to remain the same. The advanced tab, we are now going to change this to Facebook. The action tab, we are now going to change this also to Facebook. And then I'm just going to apply that and okay. Then let me also copy this. Copy. The general tab still remains the same. The advanced tab, now we are going to pick Facebook from the destination address list. The action tab is also going to be drop, and then we are going to maybe put a comment on this and say block Facebook. Okay, so the TLS is going to do the same thing. And it's going to try and get the servers for Facebook, and all those are also going to be blocked. So let me just come to Facebook and maybe try and refresh the page. So you can see the Facebook page is also taking a bit of time. Let's see if some addresses have been collected. Yeah, we have already one server address has already been collected, and that's why I'm not able to get an access to this. So we can go to Google. And you see, Google is at least we are able to do some search, internet. So you see, I'm able to get connected to the internet, but with Facebook, it's still trying to to reach to the destination, but it's not able to. You see, the connection has actually timed out. So guys, that is actually how you are able to block access to particular sites if you want to, in a very simple and effective manner. So in the next lesson, I'm going to take you through how to limit, not block, how to limit. Let's say you want the limit on Facebook to be a particular bandwidth, and you want the limit on YouTube also to be a particular bandwidth. So guys, stay tuned for that. Be sure to subscribe, like my videos, and also leave a comment and tell me what you want me to handle next time. So with that, thank you, and bye bye.